Hey everybody, how's it going? Grumpy Gaming Dad here. Euro Truck Simulator 2 time. Quick mod review here. Well, in fact, actually, it's a twofer. We've got two mods we're going to look at. We're going to look at a truck and a trailer. So if we start with the truck, it's this one here. It's the Big Stars Actros and the Actros SLT. It's by an author called WTD. Got this off the Steam Workshop. And this is a highly rated one. This is a 5-star rating out of 914 reviews. So that sounds pretty impressive. Looking forward to trying this. It does say the advanced trailer coupling is under investigation, so it's not working with every trailer. That's not a problem because I've got a custom trailer anyway, so it probably wouldn't work. So it's an 8x4 chassis, just one length. It's got a couple of variants, the Big Space and the Giga Space, which is going to be just different heights, I believe. And it's got some custom attachment points and things as well. So yeah, we're going to have a quick look at that, get that configured up and see what we got. Give that a drive. And the trailer we're going to run is the good old Baobab Tree. Ah, by God, I remember this from years ago. It's still going strong and I'm loving it. So this is from an author called Floris, also taken from the workshop on Steam. There's a note in there about the original creator, which is good, giving credit where it's due. Made it compatible with version 1.24 and above, hopefully. And it's not compatible with advanced coupling. So, yes, that's good. So I've got that turned off. So we're going to run both of these. But for now, we're just going to go and have a look at the truck and configure that. I have made sure it works. So the version of the game we're using is 1.25.3S, which as of late November 2016 is the current version. So we're going to continue the game. And there we go. So there's no map mods on or anything like that. It's the stock game map. Just have a quick look at the world. There we go. That's all we've got. I have the Going North DLC, I have the Going East DLC. The France DLC hasn't been released as of the time I recorded this, although it's not far away, I believe. But we're going to go and look for this truck, so let's go for Mercedes. There's a few of those floating around. Let's buy online. I've got plenty of trucks in my garage already, so I'm allowed to buy online. Let's have a quick look. Actros doesn't appear to be there. Let's go. We've got 4 pages of trucks. Let's keep going. Ah, there we go. Look at that. WTD Actros Big Space 8x4 mid lift. 625 horsepower engine is standard. Okay. And the last page is beacons. That's the Giga Space on the last page. Okay. It appears to have some customization on it as standard. That's interesting. And this one is the Big Space, which I believe is just going to be the cabin height, isn't it? Yeah, it would appear to be. All right, let's go for the Giga. Let's have a quick look at this. So that's nice. It's got some beacons on the front already. And it's got some additional roof spot lamps, which is nice. What have we got down here? We've got the attachment point with the rubber bumper bar. I guess that's the attachment point to use if it's a pusher as well as a puller. Looks nice though, doesn't it? Nicely modelled. Oh, hello, look at that. Oh, that's nice. Look at that. A couple of additional reversing lamps up top. By the look of it, maybe a third one there. And then all the auxiliary parts. Big fan for the cooling system, extra air tanks. That's really nice. That is really nicely modelled. Look at that. I'm impressed with that. Look, we can see the exhaust coming through down there. Oh, that's pretty good. I mean, admittedly, it's a fairly big download. It's 250-odd megabyte download. But I'm liking that. Excellent. So, cabins, we've got the Big Space and the Giga Space, which is just the difference in roof heights. We're going to leave it as the Giga. The chassis, we've just got the 8x4. Just the one. That's good. And it's a mid-lift as well. which, looking at that, appears to be that second axle there. Engines, we've only got choice of three, 517 horse up to 625. Well, we're going to do the Baobab Tree, which is nearly 60 tons, I think, in weight. So we'll stick to the big engine for this one. Transmission 12-speed, 12-speed retarder, or 16-speed retarder. Okay, I'll stick to the 12-speed retarder for now. I've just sorted out my mappings. I'm a bit used to running ATS mappings at the moment with the SKRS shifter, but I'm going to give it a go on ETS2. So inside we've got the standard or the exclusive. What does that give us? A bit of fake wood trim and some highlighting around the buttons. Oh, and different seat covers. Would you really have a kind of a creamy beige interior in a working truck? I don't know that you would, to be honest. Well, let's go with it anyway. On the paint side, we've got stock. Oh, no, we've got some custom skins. Look at that. That's nice. Oh, quite a few custom skins. Okay. Oh, that's good. So presumably these are mock-ups of real-life companies. Look at the detailing down there. You've even got the... Are they air hose attachment points down there? Oh, that's really good. So Bauman skin. We've got Blue Star Metallic, which is the Mercedes logo. That's kind of nice. That looks nice. We've got a... I don't know how to say that in German. A Max Bogle? Boggle? I don't know the pronunciation. That's a very yellow truck, isn't it? Then we've got a Peter Zerges. Again, I'm probably killing these pronunciations. But that's nice to see. And then a Vosman Logistics. These are some quite nice skins as well. Okay, fair play. That's excellent. I might stick to the Bauman for now because it's got the checkered bumper. Although so did the Mercedes, didn't it? Okay, toss up between Mercedes or Bauman. Bauman. Bauman it is. There you go. Not muck around. So what else we got? We've got quite a few attachment points by the look of it. We've got the normal rack beacon up there, which we're not going to worry about because we've got beacons at the front here. That's already customized for the stock. I see. Oh, there's lots of attachment points. Look at that. Oh, that works nicely. So we've got the beacons there. And that's the Radiant Big. Oh yeah, it's quite a bit bigger than the stock one. That's nice. We've got some points down here, which would be... Well, presumably the only thing that would fit there is a horn. But they've already got the roars on top. Are they the roars? Yeah, they're the roars. Okay. There's not a lot we can do to that, to be fair. That's quite a nice default setup. I like that. Sunshade, sun visor. We've got stock or paint. Actually, I don't mind the stock. It's a nice contrast. It matches the line going around the side there. We've got the front mirror. That's interesting. Oh, a mix of both, paint and plastic. That's a nice touch. That's good. We've got side mirror down there, plastic and paint again. It's doing a mix of both. That's paint and chrome. That's good. What's that down there? That's a badge. Oh yeah, that's nice. Oh, that's a nice little touch, that's good. Door handles as usual, we'll leave those alone. That's the badge, that's the badge. Okay, you can take these badges off, that's good. That's the... Oh, that's ugly. We don't want that. Let's leave that as paint. We'll have the steps, we'll have the wheels and the tyres, but we don't really care about those. Don't really go in for customising the wheels or the tyres. There's not a great deal of point. Stock exhaust box small. Okay. Because we can just see the exhaust running down into there. So then presumably if that's the exhaust box, these must be fuel tanks up behind the back. Because that's not a fuel tank, is it? That's a work box kind of thing. So this must be a massive fuel tank here. Wow, okay. We come around to the back. So these are going to be badge points. Let's look at the front. That is a badge. Okay, that is a window frame. Oh, yeah. Okay. Again, I quite like the black detailing, so we leave that alone. That is top of the grill. Okay. Presumably, then that's the bottom of the grill. Okay. That's split into two. That's nice. Then we have a bull bar. Ah, but that's going to get rid of the bumper. So what have we got for the bumper? Let's look at that first. So that's the attacher plus the cover. The attacher presumably is under there. You can't see it. Can we get rid of... Ah, there we go. Look at that. So that's for connecting things up to the front of the truck, presumably to enable this truck to act as a pusher. If you've got the airline connectors there and a connection point at the front, presumably that's for this truck to attach to the back of a trailer and act as a pusher. That's what I'm guessing. What's the difference between A and B? Can't really tell. Well, it's not important then, is it? I quite like that. Let's leave the little cover over there to protect it and stop from bumps. That's quite nice. So that means we can't have a bull bar. So you can have some bull bars, but not others. Oh, okay. That one you can't. That one you can't. Okay, it looks like then we can have two bull bars with that front bumper. We've got a ton of lights on front. Do we put some more lights on? Maybe. Why not? It's a working truck. It could possibly need lots of lights. So I'm kind of used to, and I'm kind of missing the American trucks that have lots of chrome highlighting markers. So the orange marker lights. I quite like those. Not something you see in a great deal, many European trucks, I guess. That's the front. All we got around here. That's the tower, which is non-selectable. And then, what's that for? Paint and plastic open. What? Oh, that's around the corner. Oh, I see. So that grill. Paint closed. Paint plastic. Oh, I see. Again, that's the detailing going around the side. I quite like that little sweeping line going around there. We'll keep that. That's good. What have we got inside? We've got pretty much nothing. That's going to be mirrors. That's mirror. That's mirror. What's that? Sun visor. That'll be mirror as well. So there's nothing on the inside except an unmade bed. Okay. Should be plenty of head height in this thing, being the giga space. And it appears there is. Okay, I think that will do then. So how much is that? 257,000. Ouch. Oh, well, it looks good, so let's buy that. Where can I put this? May have to be down in France. Who are you? Are you me? That could be me. I've forgotten what avatar I'm using. Let's back out of that. That my truck. Yes, it is. Okay, good. Let's get rid of the route advisor. Let's stick the handbrake on because it's probably not on by default. And we can't see the handbrake. Quick reset there. What's it look like from the inside? Let's get it ready. Let's get the auxiliaries switched on before we forget. Nice. Oh, electrics are on already. Doesn't sound too bad, does it? Whoa, big wall of light there. Light switches animate, that's good. I think I just saw the back up. I think I saw the high, high beam. Where is it? Yep, high beam thing animated. That's good. Indicators animate. That's nice. Probably a windscreen wiper stalk around there somewhere. Can't see. Oh, yes, I can. If you look down to the left of the steering wheel, you can see the wiper lever moving. That's a nice touch. Excellent. Let's have a look from the outside. So we've got some daytime running lights by the look of it at the bottom. Nice. Beacons. Hazards. What's the reversing lights look like? Oh yeah, they're nice and bright. Beautiful. Excellent. Right, looking forward to giving this thing a drive. So I think there's a couple of things we could probably do to start with. We can move it to a morning job, I think, and we'll have a chance to rest and get the job market refreshed as well. So let's do that. Let's go into the old garage and have a sleep. So I've got a range box on, so it's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Flick that, 7, okay. Make sure I know. What's a nice deep throaty growl there, that's nice. And let's take a rest. Okay then, so let's have a look for these jobs. Okay, so obviously cargo weight's top of the list there. Let's see if we've got any in the local town. And we don't. Okay, so we just have to have a search around. Find a not too long job. 100 kilometres, 150 maybe. That's 170 there. That one ends in a few minutes. We can't really get over there in time. That's a bit long. That's okay, but that's in the UK and I don't have a right-hand drive truck. That is only 3 kilometres. That's no. Okay. Land distance 216 ferry. Land and ferry. That's interesting. Or two ferries, in fact. But that's 216k. That's a bit long. That's a bit long. That's very long. That could be perfect. Sand builders to Triate. That could be perfect. Krakow. Let's do it. Why not? Set GPS destination and we're going to Krakow. Let's jump over there. What are we looking for? We're looking for sand builders, aren't we? Which presumably is around here somewhere. There's a garage. And it's there. So let's go to the garage. We'll start here, shall we? Nice, okay. Let's get set up. Lovely. Some lights on now. Tag lift is down. Mid lift is down, sorry. All set up. Brilliant. Let's do it. Let's go over there and check out this tree. Sun's just peeking through there. Look at that. It's a lovely sunrise. The engine's strong enough to jump up gears in twos, that's no problem. Hoping this is not a difficult extraction from this company. Because that could really... Oh no, there it is. Dead straight, that's good. Gonna have to plan this route kind of carefully. We may have to set some GPS destinations. Take an alternative route if it tries to take us through any difficult road junctions, stuff like that. The beacon's on ready. Spin this thing round. Look how long this is compared to the other trailers. Holy cow. Are they really drilling at 6 o'clock in the morning? I bet the neighbours must love this lot. Nice. Let's have a quick look at this thing. Wow, it's an impressive model. Look at that, that is really nice. Love this thing. Just about clears the back of the truck as well. Might get some splinters going on there. But surprisingly, there's no beacons on the trailer. Given how long this thing is, and how heavy and how wide, you'd have thought there'd be beacons on the trailer. But we're pulling them away, that's good, there's no real issues there. Right, let's take a quick look at this route. See if there's anything nasty. That could be nasty, straight away. That is going to be a tight turn there onto the road. That's going to be barriers either side, I think. That one might be slightly better. It's a smoother transition in. Don't know. Oh, that's not good to start with, is it? Okay. That would probably be even better if we went down that way than cut across. For sure, I don't think we can take that junction there. That one coming off shouldn't be too much problem. That shouldn't be too much of a problem. That's a definite no-no for this trailer. That's a possible. But you know what? Oh, that's a no, because that's going to be a... That's like a 180 there. That's going to be really tight. We can't do that. Can't really go north. We'll have to risk this one. And I can't set a GPS destination. Okay. Brilliant. All right, well, we're going to do a right out of the building site, then a left at the end. Hope we can get up that junction. Okay. Try and cut this as wide as we can. Luckily, there's not too much traffic around this time in the morning. Hope we're not going to clip the curb. We're going to clip the curb still, even that wide? No, not quite. That's good. So down to the end, then left. With a trailer this size, could really probably do with an escort vehicle in front, just clearing the way for us, stopping traffic at junctions. So the motor's not having any real issues on the flat, at least. That's good. It could be worse. The company point could have been there. But that would never, never, ever get a Baobab tree through there. I don't even think it would fit through the arch. please. Ah, oh, about to stay, say, please stay green. Well, I'm kind of worried about this junction. If this is, that's got barriers either side, which it probably has, we may be in trouble. We don't have a lot of alternatives. That's close. Oh, seriously? Come on. Oh. That wasn't good. So this is just the truck brake. There's no independent switch for a trailer brake. Makes you wonder, is there one? I have a key mapping for it in ETS. Junction's coming up. I'm a little bit concerned about it. It's a nice truck to drive though so far. I wonder if the mod author's just taken one of the interiors from the stock Mercedes trucks. I don't know them well enough to say yes or no, to be honest. Let's give myself some space here. Wouldn't surprise me if they have, but it's quite a nice feel to it. Please no one come up my inside. To spare. Well, now I really need to keep tight to the right hand side, so that front mirror is going to come into its own now. I can see how close I am to the barrier, and it's fairly close. Could be closer. Really need to stick to the right hand side of this road. Give myself as much space as possible. If we can get around this junction, then everything else is fine, I think. I've got a side mirror there as well, look at that. Oops, and I touched briefly. There we go, my bad. Let's stick to that front mirror, that's a better angle, I think. Ah, we're going to do this, look, we're going to do it, that's fine. We've got tons of room. Happy days. Happy days. Swap sides of the road, let's go and hug the left hand side. Make sure we've got space to get around this corner. Looking good. I've got to worry about traffic trying to join the motorway. You let me out. You are letting me out because I'm so big, you down not. Okay, thank you. Sorry about that. I kind of insisted there, didn't I? Oh no, we've got a toll booth. We've got a flipping toll booth. No. Oh man, will this thing fit? I did not account for that when I looked at the GPS and the route. This could be a problem. Right hand lane's closed, let's tuck in behind that coach. Let's make it a nice wide turn though. Oh my goodness, this is going to be close. Barrier to come down as I'm halfway through. But the person in the toll booth is absolutely bricking it right now. Oh dear, outside view. Oh, inches to spare, look at that. Fantastic. Coming out, Iveco, I'm coming out. Make way. Why have you stopped there, you raving lunatic? What is your problem? Okay, that was unexpected, but we got through that, that's good. Truck is driving absolutely fine. I wouldn't like to get it on a slippery surface though, like a quarry road or something. I think that could be a bit tricky. I know we've got two driven axles, I think, at the back here. 8x4, yes we must do, we've got two driven axles. But even so, I think it would be tricky. Oops, blocking traffic trying to overtake me. Trying to hug that white line to the right. Oh look, another livestock trailer. See this thing on the move. It's quite impressive. It's certainly a bit of a challenge. You need this in the game every now and then. Just to test you. Mix it up a little. And it's another toll booth. Oh. Seriously? There's four settings to the retarder, obviously. Right-hand lane is shut again. Yeah, it is. That's great, okay. Let's swing in. Okay, we managed this quite well last time. Let's not screw it up this time. There we go. Please, no more toll booths. So the exit off this motorway should be relatively straightforward. See the delivery point marker appearing in the GPS now. Although that's not necessarily a good indication of how close we are, because on the in-dash GPS it can tend to appear from quite a long distance away. But if we have a quick check of the job, 18 kilometres, that's nothing. 17 minutes, and we've still got around 13 hours to do it in, so that's good. Just take our time, not rush. Hopefully this junction off the motorway is coming up now. It's going to be okay. Looks fairly straightforward on the moving map at least. Oh, it's a downhill up, okay. Take out the odd road sign or two, but no, don't let me. Are you seriously going to let me go? Okay. No, I think we got around that fairly well. Okay. Looking at that blind spot mirror on the bottom right, that seems good. Do without meeting any trucks around these corners coming the other direction. But we're nearly at a destination. Is that another livestock trailer? It is. Why are there so many livestock trailers? That one's got cattle in it, okay. Oh, seriously, coach? Yeah, now. Oh. Thank you. So, this delivery makes sense because we're going to a wood plant, or wood processing plant, I should say. Otherwise known as a timber yard, I guess. Quite sure why we picked it up from a building site, but it does kind of make sense. Now, how difficult a delivery is it going to make it? Just over there, that's not too bad actually. Just up ahead, we need to do a right-hand turn to line it up, but that could be worse. Oops, let's not take out the gates post. Oh, that was close, that was close. How do you say this company name? Triet? Treat? Treat? It's a long, long trailer, so I have to take a long run up to get it aligned. Alright, this should keep the lumber yard happy for a while anyway. You probably noticed I've taken my reversing beepers off. They do tend to annoy me rather a lot. I was playing a bit more realism, of course I'd leave them on. Oh, need to straighten that up now. don't know how straight that is. No, not very. Oh, and he's stalled. Poor show. Poor show. And I can't see the parking bay from either mirror. Awesome. Right, that should do it. That should be straight. Start straightening the track up now. Have we overcut? Nope, not too bad. It's good, it's good. Let's go back. Come on, give me a ding. Hey, there it is. Beautiful. That's not too bad, is it? Not too bad at all. Right, awesome trailer. Awesome truck. Really satisfactory. What did I damage that on? Seriously, what did I damage the trailer on? I don't know. That's curious. Oh, well, never mind. But anyway, great truck, great trailer. Enjoyed that. It's only a short hop, but it's well worth it. Some really good skins on this thing. The detailing is fantastic, as you can see there. Well worth checking out. The links will be in the video description, as per usual. They're both from the Steam Workshop, so you can just you can load them up in-game if you want to. Go to your mod manager, go to the Steam Workshop, look for them. You can do it in Steam itself before you load the game, either way. But well worth checking out, especially if you like doing the heavy haulage and the abnormal loads. But that's it for me. I hope you enjoyed this. You know what to do. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Please leave a comment, all the usual stuff. And I hope to see you again soon on the next mod review. So take it easy, everyone. Happy trucking. And I shall see you all soon. Bye for now.